Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you about autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease imaging. Autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease is a single gene ciliopathy with marked bilateral renal enlargement due to dilated distal tubule and collecting duct. Synonym: infantile polycystic kidney disease. Most common sign symptom: bilateral renal enlargement, renal insufficiency plus minus respiratory distress. Pulmonary hypoplasia may be life limiting. Other sign symptom: fetal presentation, enlarged kidney and imaging. Majority, it takes teeth more than 24 weeks. Diagnosis reported at 16 weeks in a risk fetus. Most kidney looks normal up to 20 weeks. May look normal up to late in second trimester. Report of delayed oligohydramnios more than 20 HB, poor prognosis and fetal diagnosis. Marked nephromegaly may cause dysostosia and birth. Demographic age: most severe disease type poly is an infancy. Milder form of autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease can present in childhood and survive to adult. Equal between male and female. Epidemiology: 1 over 20,000 birth. Imaging: radiography. Bilateral flank mass, bulging bilateral abdominal contour and displacing bullous centrally. Pulmonary hypoplasia with history of oligohydramnios. Bell-shaped thorax plus minus pneumothorax. Pneumomyasthenia. Ultrasound bilaterally enlarged eccentric kidney in newborn with loss of corticomedullary differentiation. 2 to 6 standard deviation above mean size for age. Dilated radially arranged tubule on high resolution linear transducer plus minus small cyst less than 1 cm. Tiny punctate hyperechoic foci, calcium deposit develop with time and correlate with renal failure. Pumpkin like kidney of the hugely high signal intensity on T2, intervening low signal setup. Ripple degree of liver disease. This is T2 FS in a patient with autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease and coronary disease. So the dilated intrahepatic bilirubin affecting the right lobe of the liver more than the left. The central dot within the fluid filled space, a tiny portal vein branch. Choledoppler in infants with autosomal recessive polykidney disease demonstrates and dilated tubule. Replacing the normal renal parenchyma, also seen a small vessel, causing rhythmia in the replacing renal parenchyma rather than in the organized pattern of normal internuclear and actuate branch. T2 FSMR in 4 years old with autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease and Currently, disease so the enlarged hyperintent kidney replaced with tiny cysts and large like fibrous septa. A central dot pattern of biliary duct dilatation is known. The progressive hepatic fibrosis has led to splenomegaly and ascites from portal hypertension. AP radiographs show bulging glands in a newborn with severe respiratory distress and pneumomyasthenia. The patient has autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease with massively enlarged kidney causing the bulging gland and displacing the valgus centrally. Ultrasound of the left kidney in an 8 years old with autosomal recessive polycystic kidney and portal hypertension show the causal plus on the lower course of these 13 cm long kidney. Note the presence of a few macrocysts in the kidney. Ultrasound in the neonate with autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease, so a large left kidney with architectural distortion and numerous small parenchyma cysts. Treatment. With fetal detection, monitor fetal abdominal circumference for a risk of dystocia. Counsel on outcome, intervention, serial arm neurotic infusion, postnatal pulmonary and renal support, research support care option. Delivery at geriatric center with survival. As needed, dialysis as bridge to renal transplant. Dialysis or transplant in 25 to 60% by 10 years old. Nephrectomy when renal site compromise respiratory status or peritoneal dialysis. Liver transplant when associated with progressive hepatic fibrosis. Combined liver kidney transplant. Kidney after liver transplant. Thank you.